Central banks around the world have been tasked with a broad range of new responsibilities in dealing with financial stability. That is, making sure not just that the economy has stable inflation and perhaps somewhat normal-looking business cycles, but that the financial system doesn't collapse inward upon itself. And that responsibility is a relatively new one at many central banks. They didn't really think it was something that they had to worry about before the global financial crisis. Now suddenly they have these very big departments tasked with financial stability, but the people that are staffing them are just often smart people with experience in other parts of the central bank. And it seemed to us at Yale that there was starting to become a body of knowledge that really everybody working in financial stability should have. And that's what our master's program is about.
What we're trying to teach is to teach students to think about systemic risk or risk in the whole economy that is a risk to the financial system and how we can detect it, how we can potentially protect from it and respond in any way to try to increase the resilience of the economy against any shocks that might be a consequence of the systemic risk.
They will be really focusing on learning regulatory structures that aim to look at those kind of issues, try to locate where the risks are, try to manage those risks before it becomes something that's very systemic. They'll also be learning about central banking functions, where within the central bank this kind of function fits in. Also looking at individual tools that the central bank uses or the regulatory agency uses and how that fits in with the mission of looking at the entire financial system instead of focusing on individual financial institutions.
The faculty that we have in this program have deep and varied expertise across the financial stability and central banking space. We have people who have worked for decades at central banks. We have people who've been doing research on it from the beginning of their careers, and we have practitioners who have been at regulatory agencies across the spectrum for financial crisis intervention. Overall, we have a community at Yale of both scholars and practitioners that I believe to be unmatched at any academic institution around the world.
I was at the Federal Reserve for 25 years, basically on the monetary policy side of the institution. So I was in the Division of Monetary Affairs and was a very senior person in that division when the crisis broke in 2007 and 8.
The Icelandic banking system failed completely, all of it. And I was basically called back to be in a team of three people to do an autopsy of the financial crisis for the parliament.
I was kind of participating in and observing very closely a lot of the actions that the Fed took during the financial crisis and after the monetary policy actions to help the recovery.
In addition to that, I was the director of financial stability in Iceland for 5 years, post-crisis.
Now at Yale, what I try to do is bring some of what I saw and what I learned from that experience to the classroom.
A lot of the things that I saw there and learned there, I bring to the table.
The main purpose of the program will be that forming a tight-knit group so that when they all go back within their own countries, when a certain person in a central, sitting in a pretty high position in a central bank with a Yale degree sees the financial crisis coming, they will have an informal network of central bankers around the world where they can call up and ask for advice.
Our students get the opportunity to meet and hear from and interact in small groups with very, very senior and thoughtful policymakers from around the world. So it's not at all unusual for us to have somebody come here from a central bank from a very junior position and get at some point during that year to meet with the person who runs that central bank when they come through Yale. And these are great opportunities both for our students to get a chance to meet with the leaders of their institutions, but also for those institutions to see just how good these people are. And the kind of training that's really important now in their organizations.